Over the past year, there's been a lot of discussion about what new fighters the United States needs to field in order to maintain its competitive edge in this new era of great power competition. For the most part, these conversations have been dominated by rumors about America's secretive new air superiority fighter, which is being developed under the NGAD program. Once completed, this new fighter is slated to replace America's current top dog fighter, the Lockheed Martin F-22 Raptor. The F-22 was the world's first true stealth fighter, and it ushered in the fifth generation of fighter platforms that would eventually come to include the F-35, along with China's J-20 and Russia's Su-57. And while that makes the F-22 older than its competition, the jet itself is still widely considered to be the most capable of the lot, at least in terms of duking it out in the skies. While the F-35 is widely seen as the most technologically advanced fighter in the world today, it was designed as a sort of continuation of the F-16 Fighting Falcon's multi-purpose architecture, with an emphasis placed on conducting air-to-ground operations specifically. Whereas its older sister from the same Lockheed stable, the F-22 Raptor, was intended to serve as a replacement for the F-15 Eagle, as the nation's top-of-the-line dogfighter, or air superiority platform. And the F-22 really did just that. Although the United States has only found itself in a single dogfight since 1999, the F-22's combination of stealth, speed, and thrust vectoring acrobatics make it an air-to-air powerhouse without any real equal. China is currently developing new engines for its own stealth fighter that was actually based on stolen plans for the F-22. Their hopes are that this new J-20B will be able to stand and swing with the mighty Raptor, but whether or not it really can is yet to be seen. And Russia's Su-57 is lagging even further behind. Although it does have 360-degree thrust vectoring capabilities, it just doesn't have the stealth to match America's F-22. In no uncertain terms, the F-22 Raptor really could continue its reign as the king of the skies for years to come. So why, as America looks for new ways to deter China and Russia, are we not simply building more of these highly capable air superiority fighters, especially as we buy new non-stealth F-15s to fill that same air superiority role? After all, the first F-15 took to the skies nearly 50 years ago. The truth is, while America would certainly benefit from having a few dozen more F-22s, building new ones today just really wouldn't be worth it. In order to understand why that is, we need to be able to look at the F-22 as both an incredibly capable aircraft and as a line item on someone's spreadsheet. Now, I realize that half of that sounds really boring, but the unfortunate truth is that warfare tends to be all about where these two very disparate ideas coalesce. But I promise, I won't show you any spreadsheets, and I'll keep the talk about dollars and cents to a minimum. You see, despite its fearsome reputation, today America's F-22 exists in precious few numbers. The Air Force had originally intended to purchase 750 of these fighters to develop a robust fleet of stealth interceptors, but the program was prematurely canceled with just 186 fighters delivered. You see, as the United States found itself further entrenched in counter-terror and counter-insurgency operations against technologically inferior opponents, the need for advanced dogfighters became a lot less pressing. And as a result, the F-22 program came to an unceremonious close in December of 2011. And today, the U.S. faces some real concerns about its dwindling fleet of F-22 Raptors. Only around 130 of the 186 F-22s Lockheed built were ever operational. And today, the number of combat-ready F-22s is likely in the double digits. I can sense some people out there saying, well, then just build more. And as simple as building more may sound, the truth is, restarting the F-22 production line would likely cost the same or even more than simply developing an entirely new and probably better fighter like the NGAD. Lockheed Martin cannibalized a great deal of the F-22's production infrastructure to support the ongoing production of the F-35. Meaning it wouldn't be as simple as just reopening the plants that used to pump out F-22s. In fact, Lockheed Martin would have to approach building new F-22s as though it was almost an entirely new enterprise, which is exactly why the U.S. didn't look into purchasing new F-22s when they started talking about buying new, old F-15s. Boeing's new F-15EXs are considered fourth-generation fighters that are sorely lacking in stealth when compared to advanced jets like the F-22 or the F-35, but the Air Force has agreed to buy new ones at a per-unit cost that actually exceeds new F-35 orders. Why? Well, there are a number of reasons, but chief among them are operational costs. The F-15 is just way cheaper per flight hour than either the F-35 or the F-22. But another huge consideration was immediate production capability. You see, Boeing's been building advanced F-15s for American allies in nations like Qatar and Saudi Arabia ever since America stopped placing orders. So standing up a new production line for the United States didn't really cost them any money, and in turn, didn't really cost the taxpayer much either. The F-22's production line, on the other hand, hasn't existed in nearly a decade. In a report submitted to Congress in 2017, it was estimated that restarting F-22 production would cost the U.S. around $50 billion just to procure 194 more fighters. That breaks down to somewhere between $206 and $216 million per fighter, as compared to the F-35's current price of around $80 million per airframe, and the F-15EX's per unit price of around $88 million. Now, does that mean it's impossible to build new F-22s? Of course not. With enough money, just about anything is possible. But as estimated costs rise, the question becomes, is it worth it? And the answer to that question seems to be a pretty emphatic no. The U.S. Air Force has invested a comparatively tiny $9 billion into the NGAD program so far, which is aimed at developing the replacement for the F-22 over the span of 6 years, between 2019 and 2025. So even if we were willing to cough up all those billions of dollars to procure new F-22s, we'd almost certainly be better off dumping that money into the NGAD program or even into a different fighter program altogether. Because as capable as the F-22 is, we need to remember that it took its first flight way back in 1997. It may still be the best fighter around, but as the U.S. and its competitors continue to tease the new sixth generation of fighters, why would we want to invest so heavily in a design that would be 30 years old before the first new batch of fighters could even roll off the assembly line? Now, that statement may seem to run counter to arguments in favor of the F-15EX, which is, after all, a much older platform, but there are some other things to consider when we're talking about the Eagle II, first and foremost being that the F-15EX offers a 20,000-hour lifespan and costs significantly less to operate than either the F-22 or F-35. In other words, even if a new F-15 does cost more than a new F-35, its longer lifespan and lower operating cost represent a significant savings over the lifespan of the fighter. America will literally save money in the long run by flying F-15EXs in uncontested airspace and reserving its F-35s for the higher-end fight. But dumping $50 billion into new F-22s wouldn't do that. By some estimates, the F-22 costs as much as $70,000 an hour to fly, as compared to the F-15EX, which might be a bit over $20,000. So while you may argue that America could really use a new batch of F-22s, in terms of dollars and cents, it just doesn't make any. So it would seem that the F-22 is doomed to a short reign as the king of the dogfighters, and in fact, it may well retire without ever shooting down another aircraft. But it's important to remember that one of the primary roles of the U.S. military is deterrence, or preventing the next great war from ever coming. And some of the most effective weapon systems in history are those that you never have to employ in order to meet your geopolitical goals. In that regard, the F-22 and its fearsome reputation could be considered a resounding success, and one that we hope to match with its successor from the NGAD program. And that'll just about do it for this edition of Sandbox News. I'm Alex Hollings. Make sure you swing by sandboxnews.com today and every day for all the latest in news, entertainment, and motivation from all around the force. Make sure to leave a comment down below. I have a blast going through and reading them all. And if you got anything out of this video, please go ahead and click like and subscribe. And don't forget to tap on that bell icon so you never miss a drop from Sandbox News.